Welcome to the YouTube channel of Paroliko, and you can log in to www.paroliko.com, or you can download the mobile app based on Android or iOS also. This session, this is related to your master stroke. Master stroke mainly related to your academic preparation of CAT. Academic preparation of CAT consists of 4-5 sections. Mainly it will be quantitative ability, QA, or data interpretation, DI, or logical reasoning, LR, or verbal ability, BA. And one more section, few exam is going to ask, or few exam generally ask about the GK general knowledge. But in CAT, it will be 4 section only. Exam will be happen in 3 section, but we are, for a study purpose, we will study in 4 section, QA, DI, LR, and BA. This master stroke is related to your QA, quantitative ability, and especially it is related to your number chapter. Number chapter is one of the important chapter. You can say from last few years, direct questions of numbers are coming down, but importance of number concept is not coming down. I'm making very clear, importance of concept of number is not coming down, because it is not only useful for your solving the number question. It is going to help you to solve another chapter question also, like algebra, geometry, or maybe DI and LR also it will be useful. And sometimes it will be much useful to solving your brain teasers or puzzles, or developing the common sense about how to handle the data. And all things are much important for your CAT preparation. In this master stroke, I am going to discuss about the concept of last two digit, and this particular session I will discuss if number ending with zero. If any number ending with the zero, then how to find the last two digit. It will depend, of course, number of zero, then how many cases, different cases will be there. Based on that, we will able to find the last two digit. Then just we'll start in this session. I'm going to discuss about what is the last two digit. What is the last two digit? If number in the form of a to the power b, or you can say in the form of exponent, then how to find the last two digit. Why it is required to find the last two digit? Because it is one of the remainder theorem. It is one of the remainder theorem and one of the important remainder theorem. Without that, many of the questions related to remainder theorem you will not able to solve. Then you can understand importance of this one, and why it is required, because to solve the remainder based question, or sometimes to get the pattern of last two digit. Like same way, pattern of unit digit, like if you are just thinking about the number 2, 3, 4, 5, or any of the numbers, any number ending with that particular number like 2 or 3, then if you are making the power, then certain pattern will be there, unit digit, that is so called power cycle. And power cycle will be much helpful during entire CAT preparation, or especially number section, it is much helpful. And finding the last two digit, of course, it is going to help your power cycle also. Then power cycle will deal with pattern of last digit or unit digit, but this session will deal with the pattern of last two digit. And pattern of last two digit also following certain algebraic pattern or certain numerical pattern. Based on that pattern only it will fall down. Of course, it will depends on the unit digit, means last digit, what is it is ending. It is ending with 0, it is ending with 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever it is ending, based on that pattern of last two digit will be decided. Then how it will be found, that I will discuss. And this session especially will discuss if number ending with 0, then how to find the last two digit. And how it will be useful, means application of these finding the last two digit for various purpose, that also I will discuss. Then what is your application, or you can say how to find the last two digit and which format of number it will be helpful. First and foremost thing, if number is given in the form of a to the power b, or you can say in the form of power and exponent, if it is given in power or exponent, then only it is meaningful to find the last digit or last two digit or last three digit. Sometimes we have to find the last three digit. One of the master stroke I have taken, that we have to find the last three digit. Because many of the remainder theorem, like just to will imagine 2 to the power n, 5 to the power n, and 10 to the power n, that will depends on the last n digit. Just suppose if you want to find the remainder 2 to the power 3 or 5 to the power 3 or 10 to the power 3, then it is necessary to find last three digit. But finding the last three digit, any clear cut shortcut technique is not there. You have to follow just algebraic pattern of binomial expansion. But here, to find the last digit or last two digit, certain shortcut is there. For finding the last digit, of course it is power cycle. For finding the last two digit, I am going to discuss this technique if number ending with 0. Here a will be unit digit or ends with 0 to 9, that is very okay, it is a common information. A ends with 0, and b can be any of the positive integer or natural number, matter is same, either we are telling positive integer or natural number, both are same. Then just we'll start to see how many different type of cases will be there. Case 1, when a is a single digit number, Now just tell me, based on your common sense, if A is a single digit number and it is ending with 0, then only A equal to 0 will be possible. Now if A equal to 0, you are putting certain positive integer power, means 0 to the power B. 0 to the power B, here B can be 0, 1, 2, 3, anything. Then one of the format will be 0 to the power 0 and another format will be 0 to the power positive integer. Both of things are mathematically confusing, or many of the mathematicians or many of the books, they are not making very clear what will be the value of 0 to the power 0 or 0 to the power positive integer, because we know any of the real number to the power 0, it will be always 1. Then why not 0 to the power 0 is equal to 1? Is it correct? It is not correct. It is not correct. Why it is not correct? 0 is not a real number, or 0 is a real number. 0 is a real number, then it should be equal to 1. But mathematically, it is not equal to 1. That of the contradiction of math. And it is undefined. This I will discuss in separate master stroke. This is one of the interesting topic, and it is one of the very fundamental concept, 0 power rule. If you are putting any of the number 0 power, then how it will change if number is starting ending with 0, 1, 2, 3 or any of the digits, then how it will change based on the 0 power rule. Then that I will discuss in detail. But right now, temporary purpose, you can think 0 to power 0 will be always undefined or infinity. Now we'll just come down to the case 2, that is number ends with 1, 0. Now I am just discussing number if it is ending with 1, 0. Then this 1 0, how many number of zero will be end after expansion of this number, it will depends on power. Here 1 0 is there, it will multiply it with power 259, and 259 number of zeros will end at last, and this will be last digit, you can say it is x, that will depends on 7. Are you getting my point? I think I am making very clear. Only thing is there, if number ending with 1 0, you are putting certain power. Like here, just for example purpose, I have taken 1370 to the power 259. 1370 to the power 259, this expansion will end with 259 zeros. Then of course, last two digit, if you are asking from rightmost side, then it will be number of 0, means 20 will be there. But that is not a question. Question here we can find, like last two digits will be 0. If question is little refined, find the last digit, last non-zero integer from right hand side. Means apart from these 259 number of zeros, what will be the value of this x? This also can be asked. This x will depends on the power cycle of 7. Means 7 to the power 259, what will be the power cycle based on the unit digit? That will be value of x. And power cycle, we know how to find the unit digit. But here, for last two digit, if number of here power is 259, then last two digit will be 00. Of course, it will not only last two digit, last 100 digit will be 0, last 200 digit also will be 0, last 258 digit also will be 0, and 259th digit also will be 0, but 260th digit, it will be 7 to the power 259, and whatever unit digit you will get, that value of x, that will be 260th digit. And these 260th digit will give you the first non-zero integer from RHS side, because afterwards 259 number of zero will be there. Then x will be your first non-zero integer from right hand side. Then here we can make one small rule, number of zero will be equal to always power if number ending with 1 0, because 1 into number of the power, it will be equal to power only. The number of zero will be always equal to power. Now value of x will depends on the power cycle of 7, and rightmost non-zero number that will give by the x, that also will depends on the power cycle of 7, and here 7 to the power 259. Now we'll come to the case third. If number ends with more than 1 0, means it is number is not ending with only 1 0, it is ending with 2 0, 3 0, or maybe more than that, maybe 10 0, 20 0, whatever big number is there, that is immaterial, rule will be same. Then here, just suppose 13,000 to the power 29, then what will happen? These 3 you have to multiply with 29, and 29 into 3, it will be 87 number of 0 will be there. Means from right hand side, once you will start to count, total number of 0 will become 87, and after 87, 88th digit will be this one, and this 88th digit will depends again on the power cycle of unit digit of this number 13,000, means 3 to the power 29, what will be the unit digit based on the power cycle of 3, that will be value of x. But here we can define the rule, number of 0 will be equal to number of zeros in A, What is the number of zero in A here? It is 3, and power is 29. Means 29 into 3, it will be 87 number of zero. Here variety of questions are emerging. One question is, directly here they will not ask find the last two digit, because they know last two digit will be 0. Last two digit will be 00. Here question can be, find the rightmost non-zero integer from RHS side. That is one variety of question. Second variety of question, how many zeros will be there after this number? Means the last non-zero integer, afterwards how many zero will be there? Second category of question. Third category of question, if you want to find like the same number, if you are considered as a n, then if n is divided by 125 or just suppose 625, then what will be the remainder? What is 625? 625 is 5 to the power 4. To find the remainder for 5 to the power 4, you have to find the last 4 digit. Based on this explanation, you know last 4 digit will be 0000. Then you can say n to the power 625, remainder will be always equal to 0. Now just suppose the same question n, if it is divided by 5 to the power 88, then what will be the remainder? Then what will be the remainder? Then we have to consider last 88 digits of n. Out of 88 digit, 87 number will be 0, but 88 number will be x. Means we have to find here x, and again x we have to divide by 5 to the power 88. Correct? This will be remainder, and of course x will be less than 5 to the power 88, because 5 to the power 88 is a very big number. Then of course remainder will be itself x. And x how you will get? You will get based on the power cycle of 3 to the power 29. Then these 3-4 category of question is falling down. They can twist the question logically and they can ask. But concept will be same. Concept will be these 2-3 only. Concept will be here. Number of 0 into number of power. That will be total number of 0. That will from counted from right hand side. And after right hand side, first non-zero number will be depends on the power cycle based on this number and this power. Based on these two concepts, variety of question can be generated. Then here you can say, like this already I repeated, x equal to power cycle of 3 and rightmost non-zero integer. What is the application of last two digit? One is independent category of question, whatever I told, like if this n will divided by n 5 to the power 88, then what will be the remainder? Okay, this is your independent category of question. Second is, find remainder if number divided by 2 to the power 2, 5 square and 10 square. For these two, last two digit will be required. Because here, power is 2. If power will be 3, last 3 digit required. If power is 4, last 4 digit required. Here power is 88, then last 88 digit will be required. Out of 88 digit, 87 digits are 0, then only 88th digit we will consider, that is x, and that will be equal to 3 to the power 29. Based on the power cycle we will able to get. What is the power cycle of 3? 3 will repeat after cycle of 4. 2, 3, 7, 8. These 4 number will repeat after the cycle of 4. Means after every cycle of 4, its same number will come. Same number will come. Like already we know, like 2 if you will consider, 2 to the power 1, 2, 2 to the power 2, 4, 2 to the power 3, it will be 8, and 2 to the power 4, it will be 16, means 6. Again 6 into 2, it will be 2. It is repeating. Means this and this will be repeat. That is only called power cycle. Same way, 2, 3, 7, 8 will fall down in same category, means power cycle will be 4. Means after power of 4, again unit digit will repeat. 3 and 9 will follow the different cycle. 5 always will be same, 6 always will be same, 1 will always same. These 3 number will be always same, whatever you are putting the power. Like any number ending with 5, you are putting any power. Unit digit will be always 5. Unit digit will be always 5. Any number, if you are making ending with 5 and you are making any power, you are raising to the any power, unit digit will be always 5. Any number ending with 6, you are raising any to the any power, always it will end with 6. Any number ending with 1, you are raising to any power, it will always end with 1. Any number ending with 0, if you are raising any power, unit digit will be 0. Means 0, 1, 5, 6. Out of the 10 digits, 4 will be always constant and 4 will follow the power cycle of 4. 2, 3, 7, 8. 8 will be out, 3 and 9 only will be remained. Then afterwards, next application is, it is one of the remainder theorem. Last two digit itself, it is a one of the remainder theorem. And many of the question, many variety of question, you will not able to solve if you don't know the last two digit. And afterwards, pattern of last two digit, that is one of the important question. Like pattern of unit digit, pattern of a square number, pattern of perfect cube number, pattern of triangular number, every number having certain pattern. Same way, last two digits also falling in certain pattern. If you want to find that pattern, you have to take the help of this shortcut technique. That is called how to find the last two digit number ending with 0. This session was only related to number ending with 0. Another session will be there, that will be number ending with 1, 2, 3, 4 separate master stroke will be there. And afterwards, one of the another application will be there, rule of x exponent and power, that also you have to understand. Like I told one zero power rule, that is coming under the exponent and power. Like any number, if you are raising to the power of zero, then what will happen? If any number like 1 to the power 0, it will be always 1. 2 to the power 0, it will be always 1. 9 to the power 0, it will be always 1. But 0 to the power 0, why it is not 1? These all you have to think. This is mathematically you have to think. Why it is not 1? 0 is also real number. 1 is also real number. 2 is also real number. All real number, if it, you are raising to the power 0, it is coming to 1. But 0 to the power 0, it is coming undefined. These are the contradiction of math. Then keep on thinking and keep on learn, and just continue to the learn. If you want to learn further level or next elaborate level of the discussion, or very you can say very depth level of knowledge related to CAT or any of the mathematical aptitude, then you can just log into www.paroliko.com. Thank you.